TRPC is all about collaboration.
The need to pull people together is so strong in solving complex problems, and TRPC has been that facilitator.
It's done good work, and it's had some award-winning projects that have not only influenced the region, but it's been an influence. Those projects have been influential statewide also.
TRPC's been around since the beginning because of the elected officials and the membership. It was created by a county commissioner because he saw a need.
Going back to 1965, the population of Olympia at that time was 18,000. Lacey did not exist in 1965. Tumwater only had about 7,000 people, residents, and the Thurston County only had 40,000.
In the 70s, you had the developers who didn't want planning, who hated planning.
There were a lot of people whose, obviously, livelihoods depended on this, the developers and contractors and the landscape guys and all those kind of people. Their jobs depended on development. But at the same time, there were a lot of people who'd been living here for a long time, and they said, this development is going on like topsy-turvy here, and it's not, you know, we don't know what to expect from one day to the next door to us. There were some citizen groups that formed to support planning before I ever got here. And they were instrumental in putting pressure on the Board of County Commissioners back in the late 60s, early 70s to get money appropriated to hire some professional planning staff.
George Volker was our director for a couple years. George took the old broken down county station wagon down to LA, and he brought down. He decided the day before he wanted Wenatchee apples, Olympia beer, and a couple other things, you know. But he brought back art. He hired five people, and they were the first five people in line to get the beer. It was really hot down in LA.
When I became director, I didn't see my job so much as making sure that subdivisions and short plats and rezones got handled reasonably efficiently and effectively. I saw it as, can we make this organization survive for the next, let's say, 5 years? If we can, then I will have done my job. So that's how wild and woolly it was. So when I came here, we had neither a shoreline master plan nor a local environmental act. And so we developed the first ever set of SEPA procedures and the first ever shoreline management plan. I think that terms like growth management area and environmentally sensitive areas came out of this office. People that worked here came up with those terms. Later on, they appeared in state law.
They were going to build nuclear plants in Grays Harbor, and there was going to be a very large workforce, and about half of them were expected to be living in Thurston County. So there would be a big temporary influx of workers, and we had to come up with a lot of data to identify what the scale of the impact would be. So we collected a lot of data on the economy, the functioning of the local governments, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera, and produced a couple of very large reports. This turned into the profile.
It was a great time to be here. I thought it was kind of a golden age of planning here with a lot of new things being done, a lot of breakthroughs, and some decisions made that I think still have long-term effect here and even in the state. And one of the main things was the Urban Growth Management Agreement of 1988. Lacey and Olympia, Tumwater, and the county worked on that for a couple of years. And they didn't have to be doing it then. There was no state law requiring it. They were doing it to make the most out of the public interest in the environment, land use, transportation. And so that agreement became the model for the State Growth Management Act in 1990.
Well, of course, adopting the first regional transportation plan under growth management, as you know, TRPC is both the metropolitan planning organization under federal law and the regional transportation planning organization under GMA. And so we did a lot of public outreach on that, and adopted that first plan.
It promoted higher densities, it promoted neighborhood centers, it promoted the kinds of development that would support transit and bicycles and walkability.
For me, one of the largest pieces of work that we produced when I was here, and I think it's the largest study that's ever been done in this region, was a sustainability study.
I think we had about 500 people total throughout the region, members, people from the community, different various businesses, and came up with that plan.
It was astonishing to have all those different organizations and agencies and jurisdictions signed on, recognizing that, hey, we need to think about this. It was so super cool.
It definitely has the potential to really be the framework for many decades to come for planning in this region. And I think as we work in the city of Olympia now on our comprehensive plan, we look to the Sustainable Thurston Plan, and our council asks us to look to the Sustainable Thurston Plan to make sure we're consistent and make sure we're carrying forward those principles. So I really think that that too is a major, major piece of work that TRPC led all of us on that will have really big implications.
A convener of discussions on topics where the regional council wasn't the decision maker, but using its role as a leader in the community to convene discussions around difficult topics that other jurisdictions and the public had interest in.
It's not just elected officials from the cities or the towns. They don't have a personal agenda. They're there for the good of the region.
The policymakers that recognize how important it is that we continue to not be individual jurisdictional islands.
It gave me an opportunity to express some of my views in regard to the Department of Transportation, now the City of Lacey.
You just have that opportunity to bounce things off other people, like problems, solving problems.
The TRPC staff has always been just great, professional, friendly, helpful.
Dedicated to getting something done and getting it done well and doing something for the community.
We tend to find ourselves sort of out on the edge of what's coming next, and I think that will continue to be the case.
A primacy is placed on listening to other viewpoints, all different viewpoints, and coming up with a way to find some common ground and move things forward and take action that in the end will benefit the community as a whole.
When I go to a conference and talk about things that we're doing, the number one response I got from other regional councils from around the nation was, how do you get your elected officials to go in on that? And it was easy for them. I said, well, it was their initiative. They wanted to move it forward. They're progressive, they've always been aggressive in trying to accomplish services for the citizens, and that's the number one reason I think it's been successful all these years and will continue.